Part 3 is a group of 12 thematically linked passages exploring ways to cultivate one's leadership potential. This is achieved by acquiring in-depth knowledge of yourself through meditative practices over time. For example, if you know that all things are in a state of dynamic tension as they move from one extreme to the other, then you know that this is true of yourself too. Once you accept the reality of your own extremes without guilt, you can work towards moderating those extremes. Recognize that your inner microcosm is a perfectly formed, miniature version of the macrocosm. It is tremendously empowering to realize that we embody a limitless universe of possibilities.
Passage, the pendulum of polarity, 2.
When the world recognizes beauty, it is already becoming ugly. When the world recognizes virtue, it is already becoming vicious.
Whenever fullness approaches, the opposite is not far behind.
Thus the sage knows how to act with effortless, timely grace, in harmony with the flow.
Actions speak louder than words. Nourishing without possessing, the people prosper.
Commentary: Polarity is the underlying nature of all phenomena in the physical world, life and death, beauty and ugliness, good and evil, long and short, easy and hard, high and low, sound and silence, sickness and health, richer and poorer, night and day, everything. The wise observe this world of polarity with detachment.
They see the back and forth motion, the endless dance of creation and destruction.
In this way, they behave like the Tao. Passage, guide rather than rule, 37. The Tao appears motionless.
Yet through its subtle inaction, all things come to pass. If leaders know this, non-action is their strategy. It takes away desire and brings stability to the world.
Commentary, people dislike being forced.
Their natural preference is freedom to choose.
Even when the wise leader has the authority to order people about, they avoid doing so.
The art of leadership is getting people to do what you want them to do because they want to do it. Passage, Cultivating Oneness, 39. Since the beginning of time, all things are created by the Tao. Without the Tao, nothing exists. A wise leader emulates the Tao, humbly serving the greater good, bringing stability and prosperity, not strutting like a rooster, nor claiming power and virtue, for these will surely bring them undone.
Commentary, the wise leader knows that the myriad things in the world all derive from the Tao. So they emulate the Tao by leading with humility and simplicity.
Thus they bring stability and harmony to the group.
Being puffed up and vainglorious is a sure way to destabilize one's leadership.
People despise and ridicule this kind of leader.
Passage, Unity of Effort, 57.
It is not enough to value justice. One must be seen to be just. When conflict is necessary, do the unexpected.
Strategic non-action
brings all things to pass.
The more rules imposed on behavior,
the more devious people become, the more capable the military becomes, the more work there is for them to do, the more complicated the world becomes, the more difficult it is to find peace. Therefore, find simplicity. Take no action. People have no reason to be devious. Be peaceful, and people become honest. Simplicity and non-action are the way of the Tao.
Commentary, the wise leader is perceived as one who is fair-minded, plays no favorites and does not over-regulate people.
Simplicity and strategic non-action is the key to good leadership.
Passage, spontaneity, not rigidity, 58. Avoid micromanagement, give people what they need, and the freedom to decide, prosperity and happiness results. Harsh regimes create misery, it has always been so.
Obvious, but not to the tyrant. Tyranny ruins everything. The wise leader is perceptive but not judgmental, assertive, not aggressive. Direct, but not insulting. Sets a good example, but does so with humility.
Commentary, punitive groups with strict rules are usually dysfunctional.
Unreasonable force offends human nature. People grow resentful and find ways to subvert the rules.
Management reacts in the only way it knows how, by applying more pressure.
so people react more strongly, and a negative cycle of oppression and subversion comes about.
High-functioning groups on have inner cohesion due to strong mutual interdependence. Passage, like cooking a small fish, 60.
Leading an organization is like cooking a small fish. Don't prod the fish too much, or it will fall apart in the pan. Practice strategic non-action, and people will not be resentful, nor will they act badly. The organization will thrive. It is there in the sweet spot between passive and aggressive that you will find the Tao.
Commentary: the wise leader maintains a light touch in much the same way as a cook avoids too much prodding when cooking a small fish. In organizations, a micromanaging leader disrupts the cohesion of the team.
If there is no apparent solution to a problem, it is best to let it be and allow nature to evolve a solution.
In this culture of simplicity and non-interference, people engaging in subterfuge become apparent, and their strategies are rendered ineffective.
Passage, strength in diversity, 61. A nation is like a lake. It collects people from diverse places. As a lake accepts its tributary waters, it creates the space for people to live together. Open and calm, it receives those who come. If a group should arrive and says, "Let us in," the great country brings them into the fold. And it has a hybrid strength. To yield is to conquer. And to conquer, one must yield.
Commentary: it is a well-established in genetics that inbreeding weakens a species, while outbreeding strengthens it.
A great nation derives much strength from the hybrid diversity of its people.
That nation acts like a reservoir of human potential, it collects people and folds them into the cultural mix.
Wise leaders understand that there is strength in diversity and actively encourage it.
Passage, the group becomes a team, 62.
All things to all people. The Tao is the universal source. It is the rising tide that floats all boats alike. It empowers good people and sustains the bad. In time, it makes the bad person good and the good person better. Therefore, the wise cultivate the Tao.
Commentary: the enlightened leader makes it their business to help everyone towards fulfillment and higher attainment, not just those that seem somehow worthy of preferment. Passage: avoid Machiavellian strategies, 65.
In times past, people were not told of the Tao. They could not be trusted with powerful strategies.
The Tao is simple, slow, incremental, evolutionary. There is no fanfare, even though the mother of all things. Simple, Tao-inspired leadership confers great blessings to all. Commentary, deceptively simple in appearance, knowledge of the Tao is nonetheless powerful, just like reading this book.
In the hands of a Machiavellian, such knowledge can be perverted. The Tao seems ordinary.
Its action is so slow that long periods pass with little movement, yet move it does and in so doing brings all physical forms into existence. The wise leader behaves with simple benevolence and modesty.
Passage, humility, 66. The ocean is the great collector of every river and stream. So too are the best of leaders. A servant, not a master. They allow people to thrive in their work. So low-key, the people say. We did it ourselves. This humble leader earns the respect of all those who follow.
Commentary, wise leaders discern people's talent and has them doing what they do best.
They arrange things so that people can work without micromanagement.
Operating with strategic non-action, such leaders create high-performing teams who get the job done.
And when the work is done, the team gets the credit. Passage, compassion, 67. The virtue that flows through the Tao out into the world is boundless. Know the multitude of blessings. Three in particular, given by the Tao. First is mercy, from this comes courage. Second is frugality, from this comes generosity. Third is humility, from this comes leadership. But many people shun mercy and only pretend to be brave. They disparage frugality and pretend to be generous. Humility is for the weak. They seek always to be first. This thinking leads to downfall. Mercy, frugality, and humility. These things make you strong.
Commentary: Wise leaders are compassionate, modest, and not inclined to be boastful. It is as true today as it was in Lao Tzu's time. Compassion has a deeply transformative effect on a person's mind and on those they come in contact with. Passage: Respect above and below, 72.
Lack of respect leads to conflict. Reverence leads to peace. Respect people in their homes by not invading their privacy. Respect people at work by allowing them their work. Show them respect, and they will not tire of you. The sage hides their light. They do not display their virtue, but keep it hidden, where it is not misunderstood. The sage has self-respect, but appears humble to the world.
Commentary: Wise leaders treat everyone with respect.
They do not kiss up and kick down, treating those of higher status with deference and those of lower status with contempt.
At work, respect is giving credit where credit it is due.
At home, it is minding one's own business.
Respect for self implies being humble in one's achievements, not needing the approval of others.